ταχύτητα εξάπλωσης της ήταν απίστευτη.
Εκεί υπήρχαν κλάματα, φωνές, παραγμοί, αλλά όλοι λέγαμε να ζήσουμε.
Και αυτό είναι κάτι που μας έχει σημαδέψει βαθιά στην ψυχή μας και δεν θα το ξεχάσουμε ποτέ.
You can see with the crowd here, they're not happy with what they're being told by the government.
Δεν ήσασταν αγίοι, είσαστε άχρηστοι όλοι.
Κοιτάξτε, ακούστε να γεια σας. Και εγώ ευχαριστώ. Γεια σας.
When Greece burns, we feel the heat. I'm devastated by what I've seen today. It's way worse than I'd imagined.
This house has been in Dimitris Kardiokos's family for generations.
So this is all from the house?
Yes, all this house, the kitchen. This is to make cake. Mm. And this is for the to make parmesana for a disaster.
All the stuff you grew up with?
Yes.
Nearly 2 months after his home was destroyed in a catastrophic fire, few items are left. Just decades of memories. Hardest of all is the memory of the day of the fire.
Δεν βλέπεις φωτιά στην αρχή, αλλά βλέπεις, αισθάνεσαι μια ζέστη όπως ανοίγεις το φούρνο που μαγειρεύεις. Που έρχεται η φωτιά όταν ανοίγεις το φούρνο, η ζέστη, σε καίει, αλλά δεν βλέπεις φωτιά. Αυτό σου καίγε το δέρμα. Δηλαδή δεν είχες δυνατότητα να σωθείς, δεν είχες δυνατότητα να σωθείς. Ανέβηκα στην ταράτσα της πολυκατοικίας που μπορούμε να πάμε μετά και είδα τη φωτιά στα 100 μέτρα. Δηλαδή, αισθάνθηκα ότι η φωτιά έχει περάσει το δρόμο τον Ολυμπιακό και κατεβαίνει.
In the panic, Dimitris sent his wife and children to the sea. He then went back towards the fire in a desperate attempt to find his parents.
Παρατώντας τα παιδιά μου για να έρθω να σώσω τους γονείς, φτάνοντας μέχρι τη γωνία εδώ πέρα στη γωνία, το θερμικό κύμα με έκαιγε. Αλλά δεν μπορούσα να φτάσω, δηλαδή έφυγα για τη θάλασσα. Πίστεψα ότι έχουν πεθάνει. Αυτή ήταν η αλήθεια.
And as you ran down here, how fast was the fire coming?
Yes.
Was it chasing you down here? Were the flames?
Yes, yes, yes. What was happening? Η φωτιά ερχόταν πιο γρήγορα από μένα. Έτρεχα εγώ, έτρεχε εκεί η φωτιά. Και μάλιστα οι φλόγες, ορισμένες είχαν φτάσει εκεί πάνω.
The firestorm chased Dimitris down to this intersection, which was jammed with cars full of people trying to flee.
How many vehicles were here at the time? Do you see like 20?
Περίπου 100. 100.
100 vehicles?
100.
In this corner?
Yes. Υπήρχε πανικός. Όσο γρήγορα μπορώ να τα δω, γιατί γυρνώντας από το σπίτι που είχε καεί και προχωρώντας να σώσω τα παιδιά μου που ήταν στη θάλασσα, πέρασα μέσα από αυτόν τον πανικό και βλέποντας εγκλωβισμένους, άλλοι να φωνάζουν, άλλοι να έχουν τρακάρει μεταξύ τους.
Εδώ πέρα έχει όλο δέντρο. Some people stayed and what did you do? Do you went this way towards the sea? So you came here.
Yes.
And where were your daughters? Where were your children?
On the rock with my wife and mother-in-law. I have video for this. All this is on the rock because on this rock because all this is burning.
Nobody thought this fire would move so far, so fast. There had been no warning to flee.
Και του εξηγώ ότι ούτε ελικόπτερα είχε μέσα στην κάπνα εδώ πέρα να φωτίσει τον κόσμο να τον σώσει. Δεν βλέπαμε τίποτα από την κάπνα. Και ούτε είχε έρθει κάποιος από τη θάλασσα να σώσει τον κόσμο. Σκάγανε τα πάντα, δηλαδή.
υπάρχει μια κατάσταση πολέμου. Εκεί υπήρχαν κλάματα, φωνές, παραγμοί, αλλά όλοι λέγαμε να ζήσουμε.
Dimitri's parents were also in the sea, along with his wife and children. Thankfully, they survived. But among the dead were some of Dimitris's lifelong friends.
I have three cousins that dead, and around 20 persons close friend. One of these is old friend. I know him 30 years. It's difficult to lose a person that know so well. My daughter lost one close friend. After 3 days, find mother, father, grandmother, all is dead. Αυτά.
Best events, I think. Sold out, I presume?
Yes.
2,000 people?
Oh, well, we hope so.
A long way from Mati, Bill Papastergiadis is raising money with Melbourne's Greek community.
I've come to support a great cause, of course, raising money for all those poor people in Greece that just copped it with those fires.
It's for a good cause. A lot of people have suffered.
It was perhaps, and in fact it was, the worst fire in Europe this century. And so the reason why we're all here today is what we all do as Australians, and in particular as Greek Australians, and that is we show philotimo. We show that we care, and we care when it counts. And thank you very much.
When Greece burns, we feel the heat. For Greek Australians, there is almost an umbilical connection to the motherland. Pain felt in Greece, we felt it immediately in Australia.
Bill is on his way to Mati. He has $200,000 with him, raised by Melbourne's Greek community, to donate to those who need it most.
I'm here to do my bit, as small as it is, to provide some help and some assistance.
Bill takes me to meet Marty's volunteer firefighters.
Hi, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. Mike, Bill
Papastergiadis. They were vastly under-resourced that day and are still trying to make sense of what happened.
Δεν μπορούσε να σταματήσει αυτή η φωτιά. Και αυτό είναι κάτι που μας έχει σημαδέψει βαθιά στην ψυχή μας και δεν θα το ξεχάσουμε ποτέ.
All of them have been significantly affected, emotionally scarred. They will never be able to get over it, ever.
Και πραγματικά ζητάμε συγγνώμη από τους ανθρώπους που χάσανε τους δικούς τους ανθρώπους από τις οικογένειες, όλοι μας, που δεν τα καταφέραμε εκείνη τη μέρα.
Nothing in Mike Tsigouras's 19 years of service could have prepared him for what he encountered. A group of 26 people who'd lost their lives, huddled together on top of a cliff just meters from the sea.
Φαινόταν ότι οι άνθρωποι κάνουν προσπάθειες για να φύγουν προς τη θάλασσα που ξέραν ότι εκεί θα γλιτώνανε και απλά δεν τα καταφέραν. Και ειδικά με τα παιδιά φαινόταν ότι υπήρχε η αγωνία των γονιών τους, των παππούδων, να τα προστατεύσουν. Το βλέπαμε αυτό παρόλο που ήταν νεκροί και 9 παιδιά. Τα περισσότερα παιδιά ήταν όλοι μαζί, τα περισσότερα παιδιά. Βρήκαμε και κάποιους που ήταν αγκαλιασμένους, βρήκαμε και κάποιους που είχαν προσπαθούσαν να φύγουν μόνοι τους. Ήταν μια κατάσταση...
chaotic scene.
What happened to these 26 victims was devastating. But it was sheer luck that saved the lives of another 40 children nearby. Pushed by strong winds, the fire, which started high in the mountains, spread quickly down towards the sea, blazing through the Lirio orphanage.
Pater. Καλώς σας βρήκαμε. Εδώ είναι ο κύριος Evan.
Γεια σας. Thank you for seeing us. Was this the orphanage?
Was this the, αυτό ήταν το ορφανοτροφείο, πάτερ?
Ένα από τα σπίτια του ορφανοτροφείου.
Yeah, it's one of the houses, yeah.
So how many were living here at this moment? Γύρω στα 40, δεν είμαι σίγουρος όμως.
Roughly 40.
40.
Yeah. Ναι.
For children who've already experienced loss and abandonment, this house was a refuge.
Πού ήταν τα αναγνωστήρια των παιδιών.
Their table and their chairs.
Wow. Και εδώ ένας χώρος βιβλιοθήκη και αναγνωστήριο. Ό,τι έμεινε από τα βιβλία. Εδώ ήταν η κουζίνα. Αυτό ό,τι έχει μείνει από το ψυγείο.
This is the fridge.
Miraculously, the day before the fire, the children all left for summer camp. The priest tells me, had they been here, they would have undoubtedly perished. There simply wouldn't have been enough time to get them out.
There's nothing left. Schoolyards, playgrounds, outbuildings, the accommodation razed to the ground.
As Bill sifts through the remains, he can't help but think of his own children.
As a father, you will offer your life for your children. My children are the reason why I'm involved. I'm devastated by what I've seen today. It's way worse than I'd imagined.
The orphans of the Mutti fire are being housed in temporary shelter. Bill hopes his donations can help rebuild the orphanage.
I think it deserves our support, and we're here for that reason. It'll be on-the-ground assistance, immediate relief, and immediate support for their needs now, not tomorrow.
It's weeks after the fire, and the air in these homes is still thick with the smell of smoke. You can literally taste the fire. Thousands of homes like this have been completely destroyed. And for many, this entire area is a disaster zone. But for some, this is actually a crime scene, and they want answers.
Θέλω απαντήσεις για τα κτίρια τα καμένα, για τους ανθρώπους που ακόμα σήμερα ακόμα έχουμε νεκρούς.
Today, government officials have gathered at this basketball court to try to answer some of those questions. Dimitris is skeptical.
Θέλουμε απαντήσεις για πράγματα τα οποία όλη αυτή η κοινωνία περιμένει να πάρει μια απάντηση και δεν έχει πάρει ποτέ.
Να ξεκινήσουμε λίγο. Θα είναι ένα Υπουργείο να παρουσιάζει ένα μήνυμα απολογισμό του τι έχει γίνει μέχρι τώρα. Θα σας παρακαλέσω, αν έχετε κάποια παρατήρηση ή κάποια ερώτηση, να τη γράψετε και θα απαντηθεί. Μ' ακούτε λίγο, το που γίνεται εδώ. Λοιπόν.
This meeting is very much focusing on how toxic is the atmosphere, when's the power going back on, am I going to get my pension? But you can see with the crowd here, they're not happy with what they're being told by the government. So what's happening in here, man?
Εδώ μοιράζουν τα επιδόματα, έτσι οι άνθρωποι κάνουν αιτήσεις.
Mayor Vangelis Bournos is trying to help his community recover. But everywhere he goes, there is one question. Why weren't people told to get out of Mati in time?
Έχετε δίκιο.
Μία καμπάνα, γιατί δεν βρέθηκε να χτυπήσει.
Μία καμπάνα, αφού δεν ήμασταν. Αφού δεν ήμασταν στο
μέλλον. Έκανε μία μισή ώρα να κατέβει.
Ακούστε,
δεν μπορούσατε να ειδοποιήσετε αλλιώς. Μία καμπάνα, ή όχι, Γιάννη.
Δεν καταλαβαίνετε κάτι. Εμείς δεν ήμασταν πλέον στο μέτωπο της φωτιάς. Η φωτιά.
Μάλιστα, ήταν 100 άνθρωποι.
Μα μπορούσα. Μα δεν είμαι εγώ επικεφαλή.
Δεν ήσασταν αγίοι, είσαστε άχρηστοι όλοι.
Κοιτάξτε, ακούστε να διαβάσω. Και εγώ ευχαριστώ. Γεια σας.
The mayor knows he has to bear the brunt of the town's anger. But his family suffered too. Their home was completely destroyed.
Where were you on the day the fire started?
Εγώ δεν ήμουν εδώ, δεν πήρα the office and μου ήμουν κοντά στο προσωπικό του Δήμου.
And your family?
Εκείνη τη στιγμή δεν ήξερα, δεν επικοινώνησα μαζί τους.
In the chaos, he says he frantically tried to alert the authorities to get help. It's at this stage in the timeline where every second counted. The fire started in the mountains above Marty, not far from the orphanage. Unusually high westerly winds drove it quickly down the hills towards the town. It was at this point Mayor Bornos says he alerted the operational chief that Marty was at risk.
At what point should that evacuation order have been given?
Τα πρώτα 15 με 20 λεπτά. Δηλαδή η φωτιά την είδαμε γύρω στις 5 παρά 20, μέχρι τις 5 και 10. Έτσι έπρεπε να έχει δοθεί αυτή η εντολή εκένωσης, ώστε να μπορέσουμε σε μία ώρα να εκενώσουμε τον οικισμό.
Who should have given that order? I need to ask.
Yes, yes. Ο επιχειρησιακός υπεύθυνος πυροσβεστικής.
Right, not the mayor's. You can't do that yourself.
No, I haven't this authority.
At 5:45, the fire brigade realized the strong winds would push the fire across Marathonis Avenue. Critically, that information was not relayed to the police. Trying to keep the road open for fire trucks, they continued sending cars toward the sea. They were sending people to their deaths.
Έκαναν παράκαμψη για να συνεχίσουν από τη θάλασσα που θεωρούσαν ότι ήταν ασφαλής δρόμος. Αποτέλεσμα, εγκλωβίστηκαν τα οχήματα και έτσι κάηκαν περισσότεροι από όσους θα καιγόντουσαν. Κάηκαν 55 άνθρωποι που ήταν διερχόμενοι. Δεν ήταν κάτοικοι της περιοχής.
The mayor says his pleas for help were ignored. Faxes recently released in the Greek press show the Office for Civil Protection, which oversees the fire brigade, asked for fire trucks from the army, but not until 6:03 p.m. It was far too late. Just 15 minutes later, the town of Marty was completely engulfed in flames.
Η φωτιά άρχισε και κατέβαινε, έκαψε τον οικισμό από τις 6 και 10, 6 και 4 και εκεί πέρα μετά δεν υπήρχε καμία ελπίδα.
The fire trapped all those it didn't kill in the sea. Among them was the mayor's own family.
Επικοινώνησα μαζί τους γύρω σε 9 η ώρα το βράδυ που ήταν εφικτό και έμαθα ότι ήταν στη θάλασσα που μείνανε εκεί πέρα 5,5 ώρες και έγονταν και μέσα στη θάλασσα από τη ζέστη το θερμικό κύμα και κατάφερα να τους βγάλω στις 11,5 ώρα το βράδυ.
Despite waiting for hours, there was no government rescue. Some were saved by fishermen and private boats. Many simply had to wait until it was safe to leave the water. Finger-pointing and blaming between government officials continues to this day. In the aftermath, the lack of action by those responsible came to light. The Deputy Minister for Citizen Protection resigned,
and the heads of both the police and the fire brigade were sacked. Dateline requested a response from the department of the chief of the fire brigade in charge of issuing evacuations. They declined to comment.
How many people's lives could have been saved?
Αν είχε δοθεί στην αρχή, στην έναρξη φωτιάς, προληπτικό σχέδιο εκένωσης, θα είχαν σωθεί όλοι.
But despite the mistakes made by a few people at the top, there were many heroes. Chief among them, the ill-equipped volunteer fireman on the front line.
Όπως είπα και πριν, δεν έχουμε όλο τον εξοπλισμό αυτή τη στιγμή για να μπορέσουμε να κάνουμε αυτά που πρέπει να κάνουμε. Χρειαζόμαστε και κράνη, μπότες, γάντια, όλα αυτά που σε προστατεύουν από μια δύσκολη φωτιά.
Bill hopes the donations from the Greek-Australian community can help better prepare them for the next big blaze.
Θα ήθελα να ευχαριστήσω τον πρόεδρο, τον κύριο Σεραϊφίμ, τον κύριο Δημήτρη, τον γραμματέα, όλους τους εθελοντές εδώ που είναι μαζί μας, ελληνική κοινότητα Μερβούνης, κυρία Μάρθα Τσάμις, προσφέρουμε ένα μικρό ποσό, 40.000 δολάρια, προς τον εξοπλισμό σας. Και γιατί το κάνουμε αυτό? Το κάνουμε επειδή όπου και να μένει ο Έλληνας, πονάει για τον συνάδελφό του.
The lives lost in Mati appear to be largely due to human error. But the fire itself was a natural disaster many feel was made worse by a changing climate.
So far this century, only the Black Saturday fires in Australia have claimed more lives than the blaze here in Mati. But is extreme heat becoming more common?
The reality of climate change in a country like Greece is a harsh reality, and it's a reality that we need to adapt to. So this is the sort of dry pine needles that are left after the summer. Mm-hmm. Plenty of it around, as you can see, plenty of the dry pine cones.
Dimitrios Karavellas is the president of the World Wildlife Federation in Greece.
It's a fire waiting to happen. For many years, we've been talking about the reality of forest fires. Forests in Greece and the Mediterranean, because of climate change, are becoming a lot more vulnerable and also a lot more valuable.
Dimitrios has been warning the government that unless they invest in prevention and preparation, more fires like this are inevitable. But that's unlikely to happen in a country brought to its knees by an economic crisis and sweeping austerity measures.
We've had a real tough challenge over the last few years because in times of crisis, I think the response on environmental issues is, at best, the environment is a luxury. By others, I think others perceive the environment as an obstacle to development.
For a country in financial crisis, how will they find the funds to rebuild?
Ευχαριστώ που είστε μαζί μας σήμερα και που μας δίνετε την ευκαιρία να δούμε και από κοντά το ορφανοτροφείο και τις μεγάλες δουλειές σας.
Bill is hoping his contribution can at least help the Lirio orphans.
Κάνω μια προσφορά οικογένεια Κουκουβιτάκης και Καραμίτος 100.000 σε έπιπλα προς το ορφανοτροφείο, το The Hellenic Initiative 50.000 δολάρια και επίσης η Πακρίτια Ένωση 10.000 δολάρια. Από την Αυστραλία, με αγάπη από εμάς.
Σας ευχαριστούμε και μας συγκινεί η αγάπη σας και το ενδιαφέρον σας. Ήθηκε και στην Αυστραλία, αλλά δεν ξεχνάει την Ελλάδα και την έχει μέσα στην καρδιά του.
Ευχαριστώ πάρα πολύ.
I feel like there's so much more I can do, but it's their lives now. They're going to rebuild it in their own way and build their own future.
It's inevitable that Greece will experience more fires in the future. This month, the UN warned that by 2040, the world would be facing a climate change catastrophe, likely to bring extreme heat and more severe forest fires.
In what way can you quantify the effect of climate change in terms of forest fires here?
We do know the temperatures will be higher in the summers to come in many parts of the Mediterranean, but also in Greece. We do know that there will be stronger winds. So higher temperatures, stronger winds, a problematic management system, it's not going to work. And I hope that something will change after 2018.
Will Greece learn from the mistakes of Mati and make sure next time they're ready?